issue. You know, Georgia just passed a transportation bill this year. It went through, it morphed into several different things. I think we would get an update about once a day. But just to kind of get the high spots of that, there was added to that, part of it is a motel tax, and Myrna sent out an email a couple of days ago asking us about talking to some of our motel owners here, and I contacted Rick Williams, and Williams Investment owned the Holiday Inn, they own Howard Johnson's, several of them in Valdosta, in Cook County, in the area. There is a 14% tax that motels already collect. With the transportation bill that just passed, there's an additional $5 that they collect on top of the 14%. So they pay the 4% sales tax that the state has plus 3% in local taxes, which equals 7%. And then he broke it down for me. The other 7% is 1% goes to the airport, another percent goes to the developmental authority, 1% goes to the conference center, 2% goes to tourism, and then the city of Valdosta has a 2% motel tax and sales. So that's where the 14 comes in. You take the sales tax plus the other 7, and then the 5 on top of that. He's very concerned about how this is going to affect us, be the gateway to Florida, and the people would normally just stop by here halfway between Atlanta and Orlando. Only time will tell. I mean, this just implemented January 1, so we'll see. But I will tell you, according to him and other people in this industry that he's in connection with, that this could be detrimental to us when compared to other areas. Of course, he realizes that areas like Atlanta and Savannah, where you have a lot more convention tourism going on, that it may not affect them like rural areas. I feel like rural areas would be more affected. Even though we're a metropolitan statistical area, we're still seen as a rural area. Second thing is, in that bill, local communities now have the opportunity to enact a T-SPLOST. It has to be put on a referendum. A local county can have a T-SPLOST where they can partner with surrounding counties just to have a small regional transportation special local option sales tax. I know that we don't have that here yet, but it could possibly come. Third thing, the last thing I'll touch on is an inland port for Lowndes County. That's been discussed off and on through the years. I know we have Commissioner Mark Weisenbaker here. I know Bill Slaughter, our county commission chairman, has been in favor of this. What that is basically having a port here in Valdosta. We have the rail structure to bring things from import-export from Savannah to here, and then it can be distributed by rail. We have a north-south interstate system with I-75. We have an east-west interstate system with I-10, just the next county down in Madison County. We have a four-lane highway, 84. We are strategically located better than a lot of areas in the state of Georgia. I know Cordele has been mentioned as an inland port, but I believe that we're more strategically located than they are and have the ability to export things. What this would do for us locally, can you imagine the industry that could locate here if we had an inland port, if we had the opportunity to export our goods and services. Those are three things I could talk about. A couple other things on there: an electric car fee on the transportation tax, and there's an extra tax laid on truckers because trucks have more heavy equipment they're bringing in a car. So only time will tell to see how that affects gas sales, or especially diesel sales with truck traffic. But that's pretty much it. I'll be glad to answer any questions if anybody has.
Anybody have any questions for Al or John?
I want to make a comment, yes, sir. John. The two railroads that go through here eventually go all the way to the West Coast. And I think it would be a great thing for this community to have some, in the sports area to get into the logistics, because I noticed my daughter does not shop at the mall anymore. She literally buys virtually everything off the internet, and it's an overnight delivery type of situation. And we just got a brand new granddaughter, and she buys all the baby products off, and it comes the next day. It's amazingly, so the logistics of delivering goods like that could be very, very problematic. And the other part of that, and you've heard me say this before, but we're getting back pretty heavily into agribusiness in this area, North Florida, South Georgia. And with all the dryness and the problems they have out in California, maybe we'll get some of that business here and report it, send it back to them. So I think it has great potential personally. That's just my thoughts.
It would affect several different industries.
Yes, sir.
You know, manufacturing, if you like me, I remember the 1980s here in Valdosta when we manufactured a lot of things that we don't manufacture anymore. I think you could see a rebirth of local manufacturing, and then the agricultural industry, like you're mentioning there. South Georgia is the biggest agricultural area in the state of Georgia, and how this would really benefit. This thinking outside the box is dreaming big, but I think it's something worth our chamber taking a stand on and aggressively promoting.
Right, I'll remind you guys that already is on our legislative agenda.
Right.
Support for the concept of the inland port. I know our development authority and